Okay, so my little screen recording thing here will only allow me to record 15 minutes at a time. So we've got about 5 to 10 minutes left, so it might be more like 20 to 20 or 5 minutes as opposed to 15 to 20. So sorry about that, but hopefully you're watching this second video because so far, what you've seen, you realize there's issues and you want to know more and how I can help you. So, I'm going to send you links to this stuff right here. So I'm just going to show you real quick. So this is basically, think of this like your grade point average for your overall what the core analysis between Google and the other major companies that have tools for analyzing your site speed and your site performance. So this sort of ties them all together along with its own opinion and gives you a core score. But I'm going to show you third parties in addition to my software here. And it's going to verify what you're about to see here. But your site loading speed, and real quick, in July 2018, Google made a major announcement that their algorithm, which is always changing and always hard to predict, but that one of the major ranking factors is going to be site loading speed. Because what they found was if it takes your website more than 3 seconds, if it's 1 to 3 seconds to load, no problem. But if it's more than 3 seconds, so every millisecond after 3 seconds that it takes your website to load, especially on mobile, that's people are going to click off of that, right? So you spend all this money on the SEO, you drive people to your website, then your website won't open up fast enough with them. They get frustrated, they close it, and then they go click on the next guy's website. And your competitors are getting that business because of how slow your websites are. And I'm going to prove that to you. And then I'm going to show you my case study where I fixed this problem for somebody else. And you're losing money. And I'm going to fix it for you. So let me show you. Here's your results. You literally have a 38 out of 100, right? Your website's not too big. That's why we're green over here. But your website is a 38 out of 100. Really, really slow. And we have some categories here that I won't bore you with because it's all technical stuff. Bores me too. But as you can see, we just sort of paint them green with a smiley face or red with a frown. And out of six categories here, you've got four frownies and two smiley faces. So no bueno. If we scroll down here, though, we can see your website is fully responsive. And so what that means is that when it shrinks down onto a phone, people can still read it okay. And then you need a site map. That's a pretty easy thing. That'll be included in my $400. That takes me about 2 minutes to do that for you. But this is also an SEO thing. So it goes back to this guy that's doing the SEO for you. He didn't claim the Google My Business listing, and he didn't put a basic site map on a WordPress site. It really makes no sense. But here's the thing. If you asked me to do the SEO that he did, he would probably be saying this kind of thing about me. So in fairness, the problem with website develop or with web development is that nobody knows it all. There's just too much. There's too much. The internet is too much for somebody to know it all. And I know that I don't know it all. I know what I'm good at, and I know what I'm not good at. And I can help you because I'm good at the things I'm showing you. So what really worked out great for you guys is this guy got you to the front of the listings. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to help you convert better. And I'm going to help you maximize the traffic you're getting. He's getting your website noticed, but sometimes people aren't even finishing going there because of the speed and for all the other reasons I've showed you. I'm gonna take you. He took you to the, to the halfway up the mountain. I'm gonna take you to the top, right? And that's where that's what I can do for you. So that's your report, and that would be on your Clemmons Law website. So I'm just gonna close out of that. So now we've got your Grand Strand bankruptcy website. So let's take a look at that report. We've got all red here, and that's the one that I really disliked. It's a horribly built website. It's too big, too many requests, which is a technical thing. Your speed score is 49. It's actually faster than your other site, but it's pathetic in every other way. Here we have 3 out of 6 smiley versus frownies, and of course, predictably, no sitemap on the website. So in any case, that's that. So don't just take my software's word for it. Let's talk about Google. Google in their algorithm, they rely most heavily on their own analysis, and they will give you lower rankings and give other websites that are similarly optimized in other ways priority over you in searches and rankings if your site is slower, because speed is the deal these days, right? So let's take a look. You've got a 66, which is average, right? So it's not like, in my mind, that's a D. You know what I mean? That's a solid D, but it is average, right? That's on the desktop, like now. But if somebody goes from their cell phone over a Wi-Fi connection, because we have a separate one for cellular, I'm going to show you. But so here's on the desktop. But if somebody's on their mobile phone, you have a 26 out of 100, which is obviously slow according to Google PageSpeed Insight. So then Google also has this link where you can actually test the speed of your page loading on a cellular phone over a cellular tower, right? No Wi-Fi, literally through the, you know, Verizon towers or whatever. And they look at it over 3G because until 2020, 70% of cell phone users in America, or 70% of all calls in America will go over 3G. So until 2020, 3G is still a deal, right? So, and what you have here is you have a 6-second load time. Remember I said anything over 3 seconds, exponential. So basically Google, this is Google. According to what you saw there, Google estimates that you're losing approximately 24% of the people that are clicking on your link are changing their mind and moving on because your site's loading too slow on their smartphones, right? So how much money would you have if 24% more people clicked through on your website? Now, GT Metrics, this is for pros like me, right? Google's got their thing, and what the pros want to do is we want to figure out how can we please Google, because if Google's happy, they rank you better, and if they rank you better and blah, 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 you're a happy customer, right? So my job to make you happy, how do I do that? Well, GT Metrics is pros like me, right? And so what we do is GT Metrics, here's the problem, here's the school, here's the individual problems, and then I can click and learn how to fix these problems, and knowing how I know what to do, I fix the problem for you, right? So as you can see, GT Metrics, they have two different scores, your page speed score and your loading score, your Y slow score. And as you can see, they're giving you a fully load time of 2.3 seconds, which is a little bit different from what everybody else came up with, but they're still giving you an F and an E respectively. I mean, failing scores. Pingdom is another one for professionals like me. All of these are available to you free, by the way, so feel free to go back and play this video back and check this stuff for yourself. But as you can see, we've got a Pingdom speed test, and they're also giving you a 66D. So you have site loading issues. It's one of your major problems right now. So let's go to that. Let's go to that study I told you about, right? So let's look at cellular over the 3G here. So this is my own website, my website. I wasn't always good. There's things I don't know. And I admit that there's things that I don't know, but the stuff that I know, I had to learn at some point. So before I learned, I didn't know any better. And lo and behold, when I did this research on my website was crazy bad. So it took people 8 seconds over 3G with me with a 28% estimated visitor loss. However, once I became an expert at fixing this problem, I was able to go from 8 seconds to 3 seconds, which is excellent, which means somebody clicks on my website, there's a very high probability that they're going to go ahead and go on into my website, and I'm not going to lose them over slow loading speed, right? So now let's go to Google desktop before. So this is for looking at it from a desktop. My before score was a 47, but after I learned how to fix the problem, I got a perfect 100. Look at me. I'm an A student. I'm the teacher's pet. So let's look at Google mobile, Wi-Fi over mobile devices before. 6. Yeah, that's pretty bad. However, I fixed it, and not quite an A student there, but from a 6 to an 83, I think you can agree, that is one heck of an improvement. So then we look at GT Metrics, right? So GT Metrics before, D62 with a 6.6 second load time. Now we go to GT Metrics after, and on my own website, I'm now a perfect 100 A over 95, and I cut my load time by 2/3 down to a beautiful 2.2 seconds. We'll go to Pingdom before, and you can see I've got a grade of C71 with them. So interestingly enough, they gave me my best grade before and my worst grade after, but I still got an 89 B, which is solid under the circumstances, I think you'll agree. So then when we put that all together and we look at my my speed test, which sort of averages all of those out plus its own analysis, it gave me a 62 before. But once I fixed all my problems, I got a solid 92. So not too shabby under the circumstances. And I've gotten better scores for customers in similar situations. There's always variables, like I couldn't get my request down enough. But the bottom line is, man, I hope you can see what a great improvement, right? So I can do the same thing for you, fix your problems, and help you to stop losing customers due to slow times on your website. So here we go, finishing touches here. So you notice some key things here. Number one, my websites are clean, easy to scroll through, not a lot of stuff interrupting. Okay, there's calls to action everywhere. As you scroll down the page, you never lose that contact us today. You never lose the links to all my social media. At the top of the page is a, hey, fill this out, contact me, let's get started, right? We go down the page a little bit. Hey, are you ready to get started? We go down the page a little bit. We get to the bottom. Hey, I got some happy clients and, oh, good. Thanks for making me look bad, making myself look bad. Now I got to figure out what that is and fix it. But the bottom line is good, clean websites, right? So that's one of mine. This is my other site, the one that we did the thing over. So as you can see, as we scroll down, you know, my stuff stays at the top. I've got video embedded. And as you can see, it's clean looking as far as the layout of the words and the way that they're centered. None of the graphics have white backgrounds on colored backgrounds. Everything looks nice and clean. You can see here, now this is really cool. I could put this on your website too. Somebody can leave a review. If they click 3 stars, and click continue because they're not happy with you, it's going to take them to a feedback page, and I can actually put your video in here. I can take a video of you and put a video of you saying, I'm really sorry. I want my clients to be happy. Please tell me what's wrong, and I personally will get back to you. Or you can just have a message like this. I can change the colors and everything, but this is just a real simple for demo purposes. Now, but let's pretend that I'm actually a happy customer, and I go here and I click leave review, and I want to give you 5 stars. Well, you don't need the feedback you personally, because you're not trying to stop me from leaving a bad review. You want me to give a good one. So when I click 5 stars, it opens right up on Google. So now if I were to click 5 stars here and put a comment in and click post, it would literally post straight to Google. And now I'd have a 5-star Google review. So lots of little things I can do to help you get more reviews, that kind of thing. As you can see, again, good, clean website layout, real modern looking. You can see here for the water treatment company, again, free water test. Right, everything's clean. We scroll down. Okay, we get down here. We've got video embedded properly. Nice, beautiful centering there instead of all that other mess that you had. Product details, more about us, testimonials, all sorts of good stuff there. And then, you know, hey, another reminder, why don't you sign up for that free water quality analysis, right? So there's that. We look at Jumpin' Jays. Everything's nice and clean. You can order online. Click here. Click a map to get to us. Look here. Join our birthday club. Get a free meal. Everything's beautiful. Everything's clean. Here's something interesting on one of my other customers here. I can embed. So now we've got you those good Google reviews. We want them to show up, right? So we can say, I only want 5 stars, or I'll take 4 or 5 stars, and I want my 3 most recent reviews to show up right on whatever page you're on your website. Well, we can actually promote what your customers say about you, because people trust other people more than they trust you, right? So I can actually set it up so that your 3, and people also want to see recent reviews, right? Nobody really trusts reviews that don't have dates on them and stuff like that, right? So it's important to not only get those good reviews, it's important to promote them so that other people will trust you more based on the opinions of people that have left these Google reviews, and they'll trust you even more if those opinions are recent. So we can set it up to where these reviews show up on your various different web properties, and only the good ones show up, and only the most recent ones show up on your web properties. And then last but not least, the last thing I'm gonna do for you, I'm gonna leave you with this 2-minute video. What I'll do is I'll put that in a link in the email, since I'm about a minute and a half away from running out of time in my 2 15-minute videos. I'm going to put a link. I'm going to ask you to watch this video. But there's so much more. But here's my $400 offer. I will fix all of your speed loading issues on both of your websites, and I will help you claim your Google page and optimize it for you. I'll do all of that for $400. That's normally $600 for the 2 websites, and that's $800 value. I'm giving you half price because I would normally charge $800 for all that. I'm not going to ask you for any further commitments. I'm not going to ask you for anything other than when I deliver, when I optimize your Google to improve your SEO and improve your ranking with Google, and when I fix your site loading speed so you're no longer losing customers, all I ask is that at that moment when I prove myself, you give me an hour of your time behind a closed door in person. I'll come dressed fancy and all. We'll sit down and I'll show you what I can really do for you to really finish taking you to the next level. So I hope you'll take me up on my offer. The $400 doesn't mean much to me, you know, because I'm going to spend a lot of time doing that. It's really a foot in the door for me to earn your trust, to prove my skill, to prove my talent, to prove my worth. And hopefully once I do that, I can retain you as a client. And I look forward to hearing from you. And thanks for hearing me out. And you'll be getting an email shortly. Thanks.